It's Professor Dave. Let's learn about the common ion effect.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
As we continue to learn about solubility and precipitates, we are beginning to understand ways that we can predict or even control precipitation. One such approach we must understand involves something called the common ion effect. So let's learn precisely what this means. The common ion effect is an application of Le Chatelier's principle, which we learned all about in an earlier tutorial. So if you need to review, check that out now. Otherwise, we know that under this principle, which describes the behavior of equilibria, if we were to add an additional amount of one of the components in an equilibrium, the equilibrium would shift towards the other side, using up some of that additional component and creating more of the substances on the other side. Let's now look at an equilibrium between, say, silver iodide and the aqueous silver and iodide ions. If we are interested in forming a silver iodide precipitate, one way we can do this is to add some potassium iodide. Potassium iodide shares a common ion with silver iodide, that being the iodide ion. If there is more iodide ion in solution, that will affect the equilibrium, and it will shift left to use up the excess iodide ions. If the equilibrium shifts left, that means more silver iodide precipitate will form. So this is a method of promoting precipitation. Let's look at this more quantitatively. Cadmium sulfide has a Ksp value of 1 times 10 to the negative 28. If we place some cadmium sulfide in a 0.01 molar cadmium bromide solution, what will be the molar solubility of the cadmium sulfide? So first we must recognize that the common ion in this situation is cadmium, as it is present in both compounds. Let's then set up an icebox for the cadmium sulfide equilibrium. We know the initial concentration of cadmium ion is 0.01 from the cadmium bromide, and there is no sulfide at first. Then a tiny amount of the cadmium sulfide will also dissolve. So we must add a change of x to each initial concentration to get our equilibrium concentrations, which will be 0.01 plus x and x. We can then plug these terms into the Ksp expression, like so. Now, since the Ksp is so incredibly tiny when compared with the initial cadmium ion concentration, we can consider x, or the additional concentration of cadmium that will come from cadmium sulfide, to be negligible. In other words, the equilibrium concentration of cadmium will certainly round down to 0.01, so let's just call it 0.01, which simplifies the expression considerably. Solving for x, since the sulfide concentration will be equal to the molar solubility of cadmium sulfide, we get a molar solubility of 1.0 times 10 to the negative 26. Without the cadmium bromide, the molar solubility would simply have been the square root of the solubility product, which would have been significantly larger than the value we just calculated. So the presence of the cadmium ions in solution has reduced the molar solubility and will thus promote precipitation. And that wraps up an introduction to the common ion effect. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.